Welcome to e-Padasala. Today we will discuss the topic materials and soft areas used in the landscape garden. First we will see the introduction. Building materials have an important role to play in this modern age of technology. Although their most important use in construction achieves, no field of engineering is conceivable without their use. Building materials can be easily available and affordable. There are certain general factors which affect the choice of materials for a particular scheme. Perhaps the most important of these is the climatic background. Obviously, different materials and forms of construction have developed in different parts of the world as a result of climatic difference. The knowledge of different type of materials, their properties and important tool in the hands of the builders in achieving economy in material cost. In this module, we can discuss the materials and soft areas of landscape. Objectives of this study. The first one is to understand the different materials used in the landscape garden. Then, to acquire the knowledge about the soft areas in the landscape. First, we will discuss about the materials. So, the materials includes natural stones, bricks, blocks and tiles are mostly used in the landscape for constructing walls, patios, rockery, sunken garden, walkways, roads, drives, etc. Then natural stones. Natural stones are hard and compact, natural aggregate of mineral grains cemented by strong, more or less permanent bonds. Natural rocks are classified as igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic depending upon their mode of formation. First is igneous rocks. These are formed from the solidification of molten matter called magma in the surface of the earth or the above it. Example, granite and basalt. Second one is sedimentary rocks. These stones are the result of accumulation of weathered deposit of igneous rocks. Example, gravel, sandstone, limestone, etc. Then third one is metamorphic rocks. These are either igneous or sedimentary rocks whose physical and chemical properties have been changed by the action of intense pressure or heat. The following stones are used for the various areas of the landscape. Granite is hard and durable, used for construction of piers, benches, etc. Basalt is used for construction of foundation. Sandstone is also used for ornamental carvings. Granite, limestone, basalt are also suitable for paving works, example, roads, drives, etc. Arches are mainly constructed by using stone in the landscape. Stones are mainly paved for making floors, roads, drives, walkways, patios, etc. Stones are also used for construction of steps and slopes, sunken garden, rockery, ponds, etc. Then we will see the bricks. Bricks are obtained by molding clay in rectangular blocks of uniform and then by drying and burning these blocks. Bricks are one of the oldest building material and being cheap, durable and easy to handle and work with. As bricks are of uniform size, they can be properly arranged and further as they are light in weight. The bricks do not require dressing and the art of laying bricks is so simple. Laying and paving of bricks. Begin laying bricks. A Mason's line acts as the guide for setting bricks in perfectly straight rows. It is made of two mason blocks with slots to hold a mason line. Affix the blocks to either end of the rows of bricks with the line pulled tight. Guide the bricks. A story pole is the strip of wood that acts as the guide for laying bricks. Use a pencil to mark the height of each course of bricks, including the mortar joints on the pole. Apply mortar. Use the sharp end of the trowel to apply a generous amount of mortar to each layer of the bricks. Use the handle of trowel to knock each bricks into place and to release any air bubbles that may be in the mortar underneath. Then remove excess mortar. Using the sharp end of trowel, scrap off any excess mortar that spreads beyond the joints. Finish clean off any other debris with the brush. Holding spare trowel at a 30 degree angle. Carve small lines between the bricks and the mortar. The lines will help to protect the wall from the effects of precipitation. Then cut bricks. Most walls require smaller bricks at their ends. Before cutting a brick, place it in bed of stand. Use a hammer to tap the end of the chisel. Scoring lines on all four sides where the bricks must be cut. Uses of bricks. The bricks are used for construction of walls, foundation, ornamental hedges and edging. Then we will discuss about the tiles. Tiles are manufactured by molding the prepared clay and then by drying and burning, but they are made thinner, lightness and larger in size to have for joints. Tiles are divided into two classes. Common tiles, they are used for roofing, flooring, paving and walls, etc. Encaustic tiles, they are used for decorative purpose in floors, walls, etc. Uses of tiles. Tiles are mainly laid and paved for construction of patios, waiting halls, steps, decorative purpose of floors. Tiles are also used for ornamental parts of buildings, arches, columns, pillars, etc. Then we will discuss about the soft areas. Lawn. A lawn is an inseparable part of good home garden. It provides a natural setting for growing flowers and syrups like canvas for painting a picture. It is cool and refreshing in summer and pleasant and relaxing in winter. A lawn is an area of closely cut grasses in the garden. Lawn making involves the following main steps: selection of site, preparation of soil, raising of grass, mowing, watering, top dressing, tree planting and seed sowing. Then lawn grasses. Dhurpa and Bermuda grass is the most popular lawn grass in the plains. It is the soft, dark green, vigorous and of trailing habit. It is shallow rooted, needs frequent watering. It is slow in germination, which takes about 2 to 4 weeks. It does not do so well in the hills. Grasses useful for lawns. The important grasses useful for lawn in India are Hariyali grass, Buffalo grass, Chain grass, Blue grass, Korean grass, Japanese grass, Dhurpa grass, Dwarf Bermuda, Fescue grass, Kenyan grass and Kolkata grass. AstroTurf. AstroTurf is a synthetic lawn made from synthetic fibers. Grass-like fibers are fixed on the surface of the polymeric sheet to make an AstroTurf. Lawn-like green structure found in stadia for cricket, football and hockey are formed of AstroTurfs. As has been done in original lawns, the AstroTurfs are sprinkled with water to provide some smoothness for easy rolling of balls as they roll over the lawn. AstroTurfs do not absorb heat, but it radiates heat to some extent. Therefore, water should be sprinkled over it frequently. AstroTurfs can't be damaged by pests and diseases. Essential of good lawn. Essential of good lawn are that grasses should be thick, good green color, without any weeds. It should have trim edges and even. It should give the feel of green carpet when walked upon. Weeds are the great nuisance in the lawn and weeding is the continuous process. Normally, a home garden can be managed without a weedicide if the initial preparation is good. The Indian nutgrass is a common weed and is difficult to eradicate. The weed roots should be removed after deep digging at the time of preparation of the soil for the lawn. The next is garden plants. Plants grown in landscape gardens, parks and indoor gardens are collectively known as garden plants. Without these plants, there is no garden at all. Garden plants include herbaceous annuals, biennials, perennials, shrubs, trees, climbers, creepers, succulents, cacti, ferns and orchids. The beauty of garden is in the composition and arrangement of various garden plants in them. In fact, all these types of plants are required to establish a garden. If any one of these plant types is missing, the structure of the garden seems to be rather incomplete. Garden plants have been grown in parks, public gardens and in home gardens. First, we will discuss about the annuals. Annuals are herbaceous plants which complete their entire life cycle in one season or year. They attain full growth, bloom and die within 1 year. They are also known as seasonals. Annuals are grown in garden for their quick growth, flowers with wide range of attractive colors and for their growth in wide range of climates and seasons. They are generally used for borders, flower beds and horticulture. Some annuals withstand all seasonal variations and grow throughout the year. They are known as all season annuals. Example, cosmos, petunia and zinnia, etc. Some annuals withstand more rain than others. They are called rainy season annuals that are grown to produce flowers in April to May. Some other annuals withstand cold season so that they are called winter annuals. Yet other annuals withstand vigorous heat and grow well in summer. They are known as hot weather annuals. So in general, the annuals are classified as very tall annuals, medium annuals, semi-dwarf annuals, dwarf annuals and lilliput. Then next we will discuss about the biennials. Herbaceous plants that grow in one season and bloom and die in the next season are known as biennials. Canterbur bulb, gladiolus are the example of biennials. These are grown for 6 to 9 months and start to produce flowers and fruits. Then perennials. Perennials are plants with indefinite lifespan. Herbaceous perennials have succulent stem and perennial roots. They may be propagated by means of seeds, cuttings, offsets or rootstocks. Plants die in each season after flowering and the new shoots come up from the rootstocks in the next growing season. Herbaceous perennials are useful for borders and pot culture. Then we will discuss about the shrubs. Shrubs are much branched woody perennials which have a central trunk. Shrubs are smaller than trees. Branches are grown all sides and cover the center portion of the plants. Shrubs are planted at the corner of the garden and trimmed at regular intervals to a particular height. They also form border of footpaths. In formal gardens, the shrub border is created with more than two kinds of shrubs. Such a shrub growth is called shrubbery. Dense foliage and bright colored flower shrubs create charming, excellent beauty to the landscape garden. So shrubs are always resistant to pests and diseases. Then we will see about the trees. Trees are large woody plants with a central trunk. Trees with attractive flowers are used in landscaping of garden for roadside planting, public parks, etc. They give a moss effect and beautiful look to the localities. Trees require minimum care while growing them in gardens. The cultivation of trees is known as arboriculture. Dense growth of trees in the garden reduces the entry of noise and dust into the garden from the outside city environment. Then, climbers. Plants which climb on the support by their rootlets, hooks, tendrils or stem are called climbers. They may be annuals or perennials with a specialized structure to climb over the support. For example, bougainvillea has hook-like thorns, Indian ivy has rootlets and morning glory has tendrils. Pretty ornamental climbers display their dazzling beauty while blooming. They are usually trained on walls, trellises, arches, pergolas, arbors and pillars. Climbers which require strong support are called heavy climbers. They may be allowed to climb on arches, pergolas, walls, pillars and large trees. Some climbers are weak-stemmed plants and are suitable to grow on wire netting or trellises. They are often called light climbers. Important ornamental climbers. A list of ornamental climbers useful to grow in the garden is given below. An evergreen climber with luxurious growth bunches of terminal flowers. Flowers are bell-shaped and pale to bluish colored. It blooms during March and July. Different species of Adamanda, Antigonal Laptopus, Dutchman's Pipe, Bougainvillea, different species of Jasmine, Passifloraceae, Verbenaceae, Money Plant, Goosefoot Plant are some of the important climbers used in landscape garden. Then, uses of climbers. Some climbers with attractive foliage are ideal for indoor decorations. Climbers such as Antigonal Laptopus is suitable to grow over fences and greenhouses to reduce light penetration in the room. Some climbers are suitable to train on arches, towers and pergolas. Example, Alamanda, Antigonan. Heavy climbers such as Bougainvillea can be trained over arches, pergolas, buildings and trees. Then we will discuss about the succulents and cacti. Plants with fleshy stems and leaves are called succulents. These are xerophytic plants that can withstand drought conditions. Succulents are worldwide in distribution. Flowers of some succulents are very attractive and appear in the wide range of colors to bring a natural beauty to gardens. Succulents are best suited for pot cultures, rockeries and greenhouses. The cacti are stem plant that have no true leaf. There are xerophytic plants withstanding high heat and drought. Cacti preserve much water in their succulent stem, which is green and photosynthetic. At present, about 2000 species of cacti and 3000 hybrids are grown in gardens throughout the world. They are particularly useful for window boxes, pot culture and rock gardens. Cacti are characterized by swollen stem, thick waxy coat, various shapes and spires. They are grown in gardens for variously shaped stems and attractive flowers. Cacti requires minimum care while it is grown in gardens. Then ferns. Ferns are non-flowering vascular plant growing in moist, shady terrestrial habitats. They have been grown in gardens for their fascinating evergreen fronds. They usually grow as terrestrial plant in humid natural forest. Most of the ferns are perennial plants with underground rhizome and dissected leaf-like fronds. They neither produce flowers nor seeds. They are grown in pots to decorate interior of the houses, steps, veranda corners and borders. Epiphytic ferns are useful for hanging baskets. The most common ferns in Indian gardens are maiden hair ferns, bird's nest ferns, mother ferns, rabbit's foot ferns, climbing fern, hedge fern, table fern, etc. Then we will see the palms. Trees with a central trunk and fan or feather-shaped leaves are called palms. The trunk is straight and unbranched. The leaves are arranged in form of crown. Palms are grown in definite lines in the gardens. Some palms are miniatured by growing them in pots. These pot plants can be kept on verandas and staircases because of their slow growth. Besides this, the pot can be shifted to any other place in the garden. There are about 4,000 species of palms in the world. Of these, only 40 species are grown in Indian gardens. All species of palms are propagated through seeds. The seeds are sown in nurseries and then the seedlings are grown in the field. Then we will see the orchids. Orchids are a family of flowering plants with a unique structural morphology and beauty. They belong to the family of Orchidaceae. Orchids are considered to be flowers of romance and mystery. Orchid flowers have an unforgettable fragrance and a matchless beauty to attract people. They exhibit a wide range of colors, size and shapes. Therefore, orchids have been grown in indoor and outdoor gardens to increase the aesthetic value of the localities. There are about 20,000 species of orchids in the world, of which 1,250 species are grown in India. Besides these, thousands of hybrid varieties are also evolved in India by gardeners for attractive flower colors. Majority of orchids are perennial herbs which lead either epiphytic or terrestrial life. The epiphytic forms grown on trees and their roots are hanging down from the tree branches. The terrestrial species are found rooted in the mud. Uses of orchids. Orchids are grown in hanging baskets and used in indoor decorations. Orchid culture under shades of trees bring an extra beauty to home gardens. Rare orchids can be grown and sold for high prices. Then finally, bulbous ornamentals. So attractive plants reproducing by bulbous and tubers are collectively called bulbous ornamentals. There are excellent pot subjects for indoor decoration and home gardens. They are grown for their attractive foliage, beautiful flowers and fragrance. Then next is water garden, ponds and pools. A water body in which attractive aquatic plants are introduced and managed well to beautify it is known as water garden. Such water gardens have been maintained in the form of pools, tanks, ponds, rivers, buckets, etc. Occurrence of water garden in the landscape garden gives some natural beauty to the landscape. True aquatic plants, moss plants and moisture loving plants are grown in such water gardens. It is important to note that water gardens occupy the key position in most of the Mughal and Japanese style gardens to attract the visitors. The making of water garden is one of the ancient art of gardening in India. In those days, water gardens were created in the premises of the king's palace and near temples as temple ponds. But they were neglected in home gardens where the available area is too small. In recent years, water gardens occupy the central position in the layout of big hotels, large buildings and apartments. Lily pool or lily pond is the best example of water garden. A lily pool is the shallow pond which may be natural or artificial with water lily and lotus. This is also known as lily pond. The lily ponds are of two types. There are informal pools and formal pools. First we will discuss the informal pools. Informal pools are natural ponds of irregular shapes in which aquatic plants are grown for the aesthetic value. Any natural ponds having adequate supply of water round the year can be converted into informal lily pool. The pond should be in low-lying areas of the garden. The pond, however, should not dry up during the summer or overflow too much during rainy season. The water level should be maintained at more or less constant level. Such ponds can be made into lily pool by planting suitable plants in them without changing the natural relationship between the plants. Weed species growing in the natural pond are rooted out manually by hand picking. In the center of the pond, lotus and giant water lilies are planted. In the marginal soil, water-loving plants such as grasses, ferns, colocasia, etc. are planted. Beyond the water-loving plants, moisture-loving trees and giant grasses such as bamboo are also planted. Water level of the pool should be maintained by providing suitable pipe connections. Then, formal pools. The formal pool is a small pool showing a definite symmetry. It is an artificial lily pool. It need not be located in the low-lying area, but it should be located in the prominent place of the garden. The shape and size of the formal pool depending upon the space available in the garden and the garden designer. It may be rectangular, square-shaped, round, kidney-shaped in outline. Formal pool may be created in front of the main building or in between the large buildings. The pool is constructed as a tank with 10 to 15 cm thick concrete floor and brick side walls to 40 to 60 cm height. Interior of the tank is plastered suitably with cement to make it waterproof to avoid leakage of water. The tank is filled with water up to its top. Water lilies such as white flowered, blue flowered, yellow flowered, red flowered, etc. are kept in the center of the tank. These plants produce large oval or cordate leaves with wavy margins. The floating leaves and colorful flowers give an attraction to the pool. Then fountain. Fountains are usually connected to springs and aqueducts. Until the 19th century, most fountains operated by gravity and needed a source of water higher than that of the fountain. By end of the 19th century, as indoor plumbing became the main source of drinking water, urban fountain became purely decorative. Mechanical pumps are used instead of gravity and allowed fountains to recycle water and to force it high into the air. Main purpose of fountain in olden days was to provide water for drinking, bathing and washing. In addition to provide the drinking water, nowadays it is used for decoration. Fountain is constructed with rock gardens and pools with attractive water plants. So, finally, we will see the conclusion. From this module, we conclude that different materials and soft areas in landscapes are used to attract the viewer's comfort. Materials like brick, stone and tiles are used to construct paths, walls, walkways, drives, patios and so on. Soft areas include water garden, fountain, garden plants, pools and ponds, lawn are increasing the beauty of the garden. So in this topic, so far we can see the important materials used in the landscape garden, and also we will see the soft areas which are used in the garden are very much attractive the viewers, and the peoples are also enjoying the beauty of the nature.